Chemistry, chemistry, chemistry. Chemistry is very easy and simple and interesting, most especially when it deals with the aspect of the practical. And here we shall be looking at how you can confirm the test for hydrogen sulfide. Hydrogen sulfide, the confirmatory test, you know, it smells like that of a rotten egg. But how would you know? Is it truly an egg that is smelling or hydrogen sulfide? And that will, what will lead us to lead ethanoid paper. Lead ethanoid paper could also be called potassium iodide. Now, potassium iodide, this one simply means soaking lead ethanoid into a container that contains a filter paper. Soaking lead ethanoid or potassium iodide in filter paper. What the simple meaning is that get a filter paper, get a solution of lead ethanoid, dissolve it, put that filter paper inside, or a solution that contains potassium iodide, put filter paper inside, that becomes lead ethanoid paper or potassium iodide paper. Now, to confirm the presence of hydrogen sulfide, that soaked filter paper of acidified KMnO4 into a solution containing the unknown gas. Now, that filter paper, just get a filter paper, a soaked filter paper of potassium permanganate. Get a filter paper, put it inside potassium permanganate, and put that thing inside the container that contains the unknown gas. If the color of the potassium permanganate changes from purple to colorless, that confirms the presence of hydrogen sulfide. I think that is well understood. That will confirm the presence of hydrogen sulfide. Now look at this. In place of acidified potassium tetraozomanganate 7 solution, you can also use potassium heptaozodichromate 6. If you use potassium heptaozodichromate 6, the solution will change from either yellow or orange to green. What we are saying is that a solution of K2Cr2O7 either comes in yellow color or in orange color. So when you now soak the filter paper into this solution of K2Cr2O7, and you now dip it inside a container that contains the unknown gas, if the gas is hydrogen sulfide, the color of K2Cr2O7 will turn green. It will change from yellow to green, or it will change from orange to green. Now see the full page here. Note, SO2 gas has no reaction with lead ethanoid paper, even on triozonitrate 5 paper. Take note, SO2 gas does not. So you can use this one to distinguish between hydrogen sulfide and sulfur 4 oxide. You can use this to distinguish. So for sulfur 4 oxide, it has no reaction with lead ethanoid paper, but for hydrogen sulfide, it does. So please keep washing as you progress